Hey everyone, and welcome to another Pokemon Cards video! Today we'll be opening and playing this Flash Fire theme deck. I'm finally going back to do some of these, so this is the Meowstic one. I also have the Heliolisk one, but I decided we're going to do the Meowstic one first, and we'll do the Heliolisk one next week. So this is actually a Water and Psychic deck, so I'm pretty excited to actually play it. But let's go ahead and open this guy up and take a look at the card list before we go and actually play it. A little bit beat up right there, but that's okay. I've actually got two of these. Alright, two of each of these decks, so I'm gonna keep one sealed, and we'll open the other one. And that actually opened pretty easily, so I don't actually have to cut here, which is great. So let's pull that out. Let's go ahead and take the plastic off right here. And this right here is... Oh, let me actually get focused in here. So this is a Meowstic with the shattered glass little pattern there. And this is exclusive to the theme deck. I believe this Meowstic card... Maybe, I'm not actually sure. This Meowstic card might be in the Flashfire set, but that particular holo pattern is only with the theme deck. They love to do that kind of stuff, so collectors have to buy these sets. I'm going to use this code card in the video, so I'm not going to show that off. And here we have a coin, which is actually a Charizard, which is pretty cool. Not too surprising, considering this is Flashfire, so Charizard is not very surprising at all. Kind of weird looking pattern to it, though. Kind of almost like a camouflage type look right there. Well, let's zoom back out. Here is the actual deck box. Let me see if I can get focused. Having some trouble with focus today. So there's that. This is the Mystic Typhoon deck. There's the back. So the back and the front have pretty much the same art. Is this the male or the female Meowstic? I know that they have different looks. I don't have them memorized which is which, though. There's a little expansion info for Flashfire. There's some damage counters and status indicators. And there's a playmat. So it's got some fiery look to it. That's where we'd put our bench Pokemon. Not really going to be using that since we're just going to play a match online. Well, let's go ahead and open up the deck box here and take a quick look at these cards before we hop in and go play a match here. So like I said, this is going to be a Water and Psychic deck, so expect to see a lot of that. Of course, right on top, we've got a lot of Psychic cards. Let me just make sure I'm... There we go, that's looking better. Okay, we've got ourselves a Skrelp. We've got Pokemon Center Lady. Of course, we've got Esper, and there's Meowstic right behind it. Similar to this one, the Shattered Glass pattern, I believe this is the only way to get the non-holographic version of this as well. I think in the actual Flashfire set... It's a regular holographic. So here we've got water, looks like we've got Celio, so we're probably going to have Spheal and maybe even Walrein in this. We've also got Milotic, which is not holographic. I think that's a holo in the Flashfire as well. I might be wrong about that Meowstic. Usually they put a holographic that's normally a holographic, they put it as non-holo. So it might be this, it might be Meowstic as well, but at least this. Here we've got Roller Skates, there's Phoebus, Sentret, Dusclops, Buizel. Some more energy, some more trainer cards, a Miltank for some reason. There's a Duskull back there. More energies, more trainers. Okay, so we do have a Walrein. A lot of the times they'll give you like Spheal plus Steelio, but they don't give you the third form, but that time they actually will, so Walrein's going to be something we want to look out for when we're actually playing. We've got Muscle Band, Spheal, Furfru. Yeah, they like to throw a couple normal types inside these types of decks. We've got Skrelp, there's Sentret. It looks like we've seen probably just about all there is in here, just a bunch of duplicates from here on. Is anything new? Okay, we've got Furret to go with that Sentret, which is good. Got Evo Soda, another Furfru, and it looks like that is just about it. A Pokeball in the back right there with Professor's Letter. Alright guys, so that is what the deck has. I know a lot of the trainers, we probably don't know what they actually do unless we sit down and read them, but we'll actually just deal with that if we happen to draw them in the game. We'll read what they do in the actual game. So let me cut over to the computer, and I'll see you guys on the Pokemon TCG Online. Alrighty guys, you can see we are over in the Pokemon TCG Online, and actually I recorded the actual deck opening back on Friday. It is now Tuesday of the next week. I actually played a match with the deck already, and I won. I did pretty good with it and everything, but unfortunately my audio is messed up. I've been having a lot of issues with audio lately. Sometimes it sounds like I'm possessed by a demon, sometimes it's just staticky. The one for Friday, it just like randomly stopped recording for like 4 minutes, so there's like just a gap, it just cuts out, and like 4 minutes later it cuts back in. I don't know what happened, but it's ridiculous. But now, you can see in the background, there's actually some Fates Collide art. That is the new set that just came out. I actually just got my box in the mail for that, so we'll have a booster box of that next week. I also got this, the Mythical Pokemon Collection, so I'll open that at some point. But let me go open this bouncy thing over here and see what we got. Take a little look. Okay, day four, so I guess if we log in one more time, we'll have day five. I'm going to do the second Flashfire booster pack, or booster theme deck on Friday, so we should have that day five then. So I guess we'll open that booster box, or booster pack when we get there. But since the deck is already opened, I've already got the code in, I'm going to go directly to play. Well, let's go to Versus and see how I do. It just flashed 25. I guess that's something I unlocked. So you get these little Thunderbolts. I think you get those after winning matches. So you can unlock some certain cards. You can even unlock booster packs, it looks like, EXs. So if you play a whole bunch, it looks like you can unlock a whole lot of stuff. But Yeah, it's going to take you 2,000 points, which I think is like 200 wins, but you do get a lot of stuff. You get like 5 boost spectra there. It's pretty cool. But let me just go ahead and choose my deck if I can find it. There we go, Mystic Typhoon. Let's hit play, see if it finds an opponent here. And it battled him pretty quick. Seems like there's a decent amount of people playing. So he's got a Yveltal deck. It looks like from the base set X and Y. I'm going to go ahead and call heads on the coin right here. And I won. Okay. I think I'm going to choose to go first. Would I like to go first? Sure. So they've got a Dark and Psychic, I think it was. I only got a short glimpse at what type it was. Let's see. So we've got to choose an active Pokemon here. So I could put out Miltank. Actually, the first time I played this deck last week, Miltank destroyed some stuff. Once I got to that Powerful Friends. Actually, no, it was Hammerin that I got powered up with. Powerful Friends is great if you can get that far, but... Okay, to start, we've got Milotic right here, so I could go for that. I could go Phoebus and then power up, but Phoebus is very weak. I think I'm going to put Skrelp to start while I power up some other stuff here. Let's just go ahead and hit done. For some reason, it looks like the resolution of the game is kind of low. I don't know if I can change that real quick. Let me go settings, video. Yeah, it looks like it's kind of low, so let me just turn that up real quick and see if that changes anything. I think it's a little bit crisper now. Anyways, let's go ahead and I guess put down a Phoebus on the bench. We'll put down Miltank as well. And we'll call it done there. So let's go ahead and... Oh wait, can I play this? Flip a coin of heads, draw 3 cards? Sure, why not? We'll go ahead and play the Roller Skates. Got a tail so I don't get to draw anything right there. Okie dokie. So we'll just go ahead and end our turn and let our... Oops. I should have attached an energy. Wow, I'm an idiot. Okay. Well, oh well. I want to power up this guy. Honestly, I don't really care that much about Skrelp, although this guy's got an Yveltal directly out right here, so that could be very deadly if I can't take that out real quick. And Waterfall's not going to one-shot it at all. It's actually going to take 2 of those just to kill it. Man, I don't have anything to take care of that Yveltal, actually. Let's see, we drew a water energy. Should I try to poison him with spit poison? Let's flip a coins. Ah, man. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and power up this guy. We'll try to get to Milotic. Let's see, once during your turn before you attack, you may knock out this Pokemon. If you do, attach 3 basic energy cards from your discard pile to one of your Pokemon, excluding Pokemon EX. I could use that to power up Miltank, but I don't have any energies in my discard pile right now, so that's kind of an issue. So I guess we're just going to go ahead and end our turn right there. Actually, let's just in case he does something crazy, I'm going to go ahead and power up right here. So we'll do that. Okay. So we'll go ahead and end turn. Now I've got to get 2 more energies on that, which would have not been that big of an issue if I was not an idiot and forgot to attach one the first turn. And it looks like he's putting down a Dunsparce. He's also going to play Professor's Letter, which lets him search for a couple of basic energy cards. So he's probably going to try to power up for that Darkness Blade. If he gets that, I'm basically going to lose because that'll one-shot my Milotic. It'll one-shot my Miltank because it hits for 100 damage, it looks like. There goes another Oblivion Wing, and Skrelp is defeated. Crud, dude. Let's take a look here. So, flip a coin if Chelsea's attack can't attack during your next turn. Okay, so we might have some survivability with that. So for now, we're going to go ahead and send out Miltank just to take a hit while we power up Milotic. Because if he gets one more energy card out, we are not in a good spot. So we're going to go ahead and power up our Waterfall a little bit more. I guess I'm going to have to put something down here. I think what we're going to do is I don't know, man. This looks like a very dire situation. I just cannot see me actually winning this right now. This just looks like it's going to be a bad time, but we're going to keep trying. Let's see. Yep, he's powered up. He's going to have to flip a coin. If he gets Tails, then he won't be able to attack next turn, but that's not going to matter that much right here. He goes for an Evo Soda. Search your deck for a card that evolves from one of your Pokemon and put it onto that Pokemon. So he could evolve any of these Pokemon right here. It looks like he's searching right now. He might go for a Swellow, might go for a Zoroark. Man, this is rough. This is very rough. I wish I had the recording. Actually, I still have the video recording of the first game, but I did so much better in that. Miltank actually was wrecking some face, and it wasn't like a complete stomp. Like, I didn't just completely wreck them. It was a pretty good match. Like, it was pretty even, and those are my favorite. Are matches that are pretty close, but I ended up winning that one, which is great. This one, it looks like I'm just going to get completely stomped. I can't see any way out of this unless I draw something really fancy. But ow, that was loud as crud. Out comes Darkness Blade. He gets a tail, so we cannot attack with that next turn. With that said, we have no way to kill him in any kind of quick fashion. So I'm going to have to send out a Buizel right here. And we're going to have to play some Roller Skates. Let's see what we got. We got a head, so I get to draw 3 cards. That gives me some energy, which is great. So what I'm going to do is power up, go for the Water Gun. He's going to kill my guy. Hopefully he'll get Tails, then I do attack. But then he'll just kill me anyways. I don't think there's any way I can survive this unless I play like this. I don't know, guys. I don't think there's any way I can survive this right now. So we're just going to go through the motions of this defeat pretty much. So he cannot attack this turn, but... Oh, wait. He can't attack at all. I thought it was just he couldn't attack with his one thing. So I guess we can whittle him down a little bit with Buizel, but I don't know. It's probably not going to make too big of a difference here. He's going to shuffle his hand into his deck, then draw 5 cards. We'll see how that goes. Okay. He goes 5 cards. Does he get anything fancy? He got himself a sand dial, and he's powering that up with an energy card. And it's back over to my turn here. Let's see. We've got a psychic energy, which is great. So I think what I'm going to have to do is... try to whittle him down a little bit more. I can go for the waterfall. I can retreat and go for waterfall. But if I do that, he's just going to use a darkness blade and kill me. So I think instead we're going to power up our Buizel. Let's use the psychic energy there. And we're going to go for a quick attack. Try to get a little bit of damage. I just don't see... Well, we got tails. So that was a complete waste. I don't see any way this is not going to go terrible for us. So... oh boy. What do you go for, dude? He's going to go for... well, he's going to evolve his sand dial. Let's just give me some tips about how evolution works. He's got a Krokorok out here. This is not good, guys. Evil Tall is probably going to go for Darkness Blade. Yes, he will. He might get a Tails, but it's just at the point where it... I don't know if it actually matters. Actually, maybe we can do this. Okay. So here's... no, we got a Heads, though. Gosh dang it! That was my chance. So what could have happened is he got Tails. I attack. He couldn't attack. Then I attack again. Take him down. But unfortunately... he did not get Tails, so I have to send out Sveal. He needs to get Tails for me to send out Milotic and actually take this guy down. So at this point, we're going to power up our Milotic. I guess we'll put Duskull back on the board here and end our turn. Sveal has to just take a hit. He just needs to get Tails. I don't have that many more prize cards for him to go through for me to take his sacrifices here. So there's almost no way I can get through this. The only way is if I get through this guy. Get Tails! Okay, so maybe we've got a chance right here, guys. Milotic might be able to bring this back. We'll put them out, and we'll go for the waterfall. I hope you guys have been seeing what I'm trying to do here. I'm trying to stall out. Let's see. I guess I'll put down Esper and power them up. Maybe I'll get a Meowstic, the mascot of this deck. And we're going to go for a waterfall. Now, I think he can still retreat. If he does that, we're probably dead. But maybe he won't think of that. Maybe he won't retreat. And then next turn, I can just use Waterfall and take them down. Now, if he does retreat, we still might be in this. We'll just have to see how it goes. So this is... oh, he has a potion. Well, great. Well, he is now 10 damage away from death if I attack him right here. Actually, 20 even. So now there's no way I can kill him. I have to retreat, which costs 2 energy cards. And then in the process of powering up... he's just going to take it. So I think at this point, there's nothing I can possibly hope for. That potion sealed the deal. So we're going to go ahead and concede. All right. Good game, dude. I definitely lost there. Oh, well. That one ends in our defeat. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Sorry this did not go up on Friday last time, but we'll have another theme deck match with the other Flashfire theme deck. Hopefully that one goes a little bit better for me on video because this one did not seem to go so well. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Take care.